Hi, welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial, I will show you how to create and use an iPad image background. Okay, to make you understand what an iPad image background is, let's take a look at this text view. Okay, in this text view, I just assign the dummy message by using IPSum to simulate a case where the content is larger than the background, and I assign the background, okay, it's normal background, to this text view, and you will see the problem that the contents overlay on the logo of the background that is not suitable, right? Okay, and you will see that the logo of your background is not proportional. To solve this problem, we have to use the iPad image technique. Okay, let me change this background to another one that using the iPad technique. And right now you will see that the logo is proportional, it's not weird. And the content is below, okay, and the content is below the logo, okay, that is what we expect, right? Okay, and right now let's create an iPad image. To create an iPad image, very easy, by duplicate the original one, okay, and I will change the name a little bit by changing from org to new and add .9. Okay, this is very important to add .9 before your file extension. Okay, I will enter. Okay, and I will go back to the layout and change, okay, to this. And you see that after I change to the iPad image, there's still the problem. Okay, there's still the problem here because we haven't yet specified the scalable area, okay, to solve this problem. Okay, let me open the iPad image. When I open the iPad image, you will see that it's quite different to the open the normal image. This is a way to this is a case that I open the normal image. This is a case that I open the iPad image. When you open the iPad image, it seems like you entering into the editing mode. Okay, image editing mode. In this mode, there will be four guidelines like this. Okay, in this four guidelines allow you to set the scalable area, okay, for top and left. Okay, for top and left, this is a guideline that allow you to set scalable area on horizontal and on vertical. And for right and bottom, okay, for right and bottom, this is a way to let you specify the area of your content. Okay, if you don't want your content overlay your logo, okay, you have to set your content area below your logo. Okay, but I will teach you how to set the scalable area on the horizontal and vertical first. Okay, to do this, you just move your mouse a little bit around here, and you will see the guideline. You can move, okay, and you will see the black line. In this black line, it allow you to specify the scalable area, and you will see that this is preview. When you scroll down in the preview, in the horizontal mode. In this mode, you will see it try to expand your background to simulate when the width of your background is larger. There will be the problem or not. And you will see that right now the logo is not weird anymore. It's keep proportional, but it's still not symmetric because I just assign scalable area on left only. To solve this problem, I just assign another scalable area. To assign another scalable area, I just drag my mouse around the edge. Okay, if you zoom the background, you will see that there is some like a 1 pixel at every edge of every your orientation. Okay, top, left, right, and bottom. Okay, and after you assign the background, you can adjust the size, okay, to make your logo keep symmetry, okay, to make your logo located in the center on the horizontal. And then you see that on the horizontal mode, the problem there still is a problem, right? So that you have to adjust the scalable area on the horizontal mode. In this case, you have to adjust by adjust the size of this. In the left hand side. Okay, and you see right now there is no problem, but if you can see, you can see that the background, and you can see like a shadow. You see that the shadow is weird a little bit because the guideline is overlay on the shadow. To solve this problem, you have to shift it down. Okay, you have to move it down to not overlay on your shadow. Okay, and right now you see that the background can display perfectly. I will save and get back to the layout. I will refresh. Okay, and you see that right now the logo of your background can display proportional. Okay, but it's still not suitable because the content still keep overlay on your logo. To solve this problem, you have to go back to your notepad and you have to specify on line, okay, right hand side and the bottom. Okay, this part allows you to specify the content area. To make your content below your logo, you have to adjust it something like this. Okay, you will see the back line. Okay, if you want your content below your logo, okay, below your shadow, you have to try to adjust. Okay, and not to close to the bottom. You have to shape up your backline. Okay, I will save and see the result. Let me refresh, and you see right now your content is below your logo and it's not too close to the bottom. And you will see that that is still close to the left hand side and the right hand side edge of your background. Okay, so you have to add more padding. To add more padding, you have to adjust on the bottom. Okay, to keep your content not too close to the edge. Okay, and then go back and then refresh. Okay, and right now you will see that your content can display on the background perfectly. Okay, and background is not weird anymore. It's keep very proportional. Now even your size of image will change difference. I will change size of your I will change the content like a lower. And you see that even smaller content or larger content, there is no any problem. Okay, thank you for watching this tutorial and hope to see you again in next tutorial. Goodbye.